fans, welcome to NRG Stadium in Houston. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the New York Jets and the Houston Texans. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line.
Shoot with my man D. Watson on a 2-game win streak with the offense so far. Three and one total.
Quickly. On the ground, this is Lamar Miller. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
They keep it with Miller on first down. He fights forward for a couple with a penalty flag down. And the linemen, they're already walking back. That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
The gun. Here's Watson. He's got four. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. To throw on second is Watson. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
And with a third and 14, we have 6 defensive backs out there now defensively.
Come on, let's go! Red 38!
A shotgun snap for Watson. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. A first down carry now for Miller. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Second down following the run. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. He lost 2 there, and it's third down.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
So a 3rd and 10, and defensively, a dime look, 6 DBs. Play clock winding down.
Here we go.
Throwing on 3rd down, Watson. Underneath for Miller. And he's going to have the 1st down yardage to the 35. A pickup of 11 at a Texans 1st down. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. To the ground now with Miller. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
That's a strong pickup right there on 1st down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. To throw is Watson. From the gun, he'll throw. And an alley to run. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. A good decision in the end to pull it and run. Gets him 9 yards at a first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
So here we go, 1st and 10 now. They'll run it here. This is Deontay Foreman. He's dropped just inside the 20. A little second effort there, but couldn't find a whole lot of space. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. And the seemingly endless drive continues. Watson, a bootleg. Got a man open. It's Fuller for the Texans touchdown. Will Fuller, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Texans take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. No back out now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. And Austin Seferian Jenkins has it. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards for the Jets there as they've got themselves a first down. Now the offense lining up first and 10. With Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Jets in possession as we begin quarter number two here. And they've got it here with a first down. Now Stafford. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Had an open man that time. They ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. So second and 10 here. Throwing again. Stafford. And that'll be incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. And it's third down.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Throwing on third down, Stafford. Caught, Seferian Jenkins, right side. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. One past the 30 down to the 25. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Another 13 yards there twice in a row, and they're on the move. Another first down as well.
That's another nice run, and I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open. But other coaches said, you know something? Until they stop him, that big boy's going to keep getting the football. And that might be the direction that they're going to go right now.
They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
A handoff as they run the counter play. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays, exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
And the Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Stafford now to throw. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A short gain there of just four, and that'll bring up a fourth down. So on fourth down, out comes the field goal unit for Todd Bowles. And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
Now after the made field goal, Catanzaro to boot this one away on the kickoff. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And here comes the Texans now. It was countered by just
that's
a field goal.
Kind of
so, hey, if here. Your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
Start out on the ground. It's Lamar Miller. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you could see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
Watson now on second down. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. They were trying to get the connection with a former Buckeye, Braxton Miller. And that'll make it third down. Action for Miller. Now Watson. He's going to fire one deep over. And got his man complete. And they finally get him, but not before he reaches the 33-yard line. It's a big play on third down for the Texans. 45 yards. First and 10, Watson gets it to Gordon. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. To play here in the first half. We're back to Houston after this timeout. They'll run it now out of the gun. And now, and the Jets have recovered. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offense is.
Boy, you fumble every game, man.
In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Made a play.
As a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because, you know, those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Stafford now on second down. Buying time to his left. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Why? The clock will stop with 37 seconds
Why?
To play in
Why
this first
for the
half.
Face? I thought I passed a minute. I might did.
And now a first down following that long gain. Zone now, Stafford. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13. That's caught right side by Anderson. That catch good for 5. It's third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. To throw on third down, Stafford. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
Well, that was excellent coverage right there, and he definitely did the right thing, showing that discretion is definitely the better part of valor. Threw it away. preserved the opportunity to kick for a field goal.
And excellent coverage. And right now, the human is controlling the defense, so good job, human. They're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good.
Good job, human.
They've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be.
It's one of the goddamn guy on opportunities, man.
That's fielded in the end zone.
It's going to opportunities, Mike.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and then bring the football out to the 25. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And from this spot on the field, the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And with time running down, they go down to a knee. So a very tight first half. We had to break in a one-point game. As we send you on over to Orlando, where we'll check in with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports halftime report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Now the Jet offense about to take over as they head out onto the field. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up. And we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Here's Stafford. And to the tight end here, Safarian Jenkins. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Jet first down. They'll bring a receiver in motion left.
Now the Texans are going to stop. I can't even fucking make adjustments without all this damn crap.
It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
The
yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And it'll be a second and long. To throw is Stafford. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
The Jets on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be third and 15. Now it's Stafford. The quick hitter complete. It's Anderson. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Here's Lachlan Edwards now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin them back. So here's the Texans offense now. They get set to start this third quarter. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Watson on first down. And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes. DeMario Davis in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
Why they make me move like that? What the fuck is going
back
on?
In his own 5-yard line, it's a sack.
Come on, man. Shit.
In there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year.
That fucking made me roll out to the... Why there go?
Something special here on 3rd and long. After that sack, what does Watson have in his arsenal? Watson hands to Miller on the draw. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. 9 yards on the carry there, but it'll be 4th down now.
As much as I praise teams for being true to who they are, in this situation, I wonder if maybe they outguessed themselves a little bit. 3rd down, seemed like an obvious passing situation. They chose to run it and didn't get anywhere close to a 1st down.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one goes sailing out of bounds. Where did it cross? Well, they're going to say on this side of midfield. And New York set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They run the counter now on 1st down. And oh, he coughed it up. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And
how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Now a 1st down throw, Watson. And that is incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
Oh, I want it there.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll set up for 3rd down.
Getting out a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. The Texans on 3rd down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5.
Oh, baby.
Here we go. Ohio. Ohio. Flex round. Flex round.
From the gun, here's Watson.
Watson, come on, man. Come on, Watson.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here.
Come on, Watson.
They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through
the air. Throwing
the
ball to, man.
Successful.
Here's Garrett Swanson now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And they'll let this one go right on the outskirts of the 10. They'll down it at the 11-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, and pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Stafford, he's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a second
down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Second down of the offense needing 5 yards. Shotgun snap for Stafford. Dancing to his left. Now he's going to throw deep back over the middle. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly to sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Third down, here's Forte. And not much there at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line. Just a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. Here's Lachlan Edwards now, standing just outside his own goal line.
And wipes. Don't forget your wipes.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And now out comes Houston. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Thank you. What? No. Stop. The wipes.
They begin with a run by Miller. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments.
Don't get them out.
Back now here on EA Sports. And we've got a day to hear one point game as we begin the fourth.
By the bathroom.
Up for the offense as they face a second and 11.
Come on, let's go! Black round!
A shotgun snap for Watson. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Gordon. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
The Texans on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 4.
Come on, let's go! Red 38!
Out of the gun, Watson. He finds his target, Fuller. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. Well, we had a number of good games in the afternoon sessions, but this Sunday nighter might top them all. So we come up here on 1st and 10. Time running out here on the play clock. They'll try and run some clock here with Miller. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. So the solid run on first, and I would imagine no real hurry to run that second down play.
No, it's all on your quarterback now. He's going to keep an eye on the play clock and bleed things down, and he's not going to let the ball be snapped until it's inside 3 seconds left on the play clock. Unless, of course, you're playing a video game, you're trying to run it up on your friend.
Nice touch. Cold-blooded, too. Watson. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
Second down, here's Watson. It's complete to Fuller. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front. Defensive end, defensive tackle, doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
On first down, Watson throwing the out route incomplete. That's Miller. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the 2. A good pickup there, a 22.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They isolate Hopkins on the left side. Now it's Watson. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. DeAndre Hopkins with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Texans will extend their lead.
Ooh, I hate this
and
game.
He puts it through.
It made me get a blocked field goal down there. Every game I got to get blocked. My field goal's going to get blocked.
No back out now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now out come the Jets. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs. and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Here's Stanford. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. Jadeveon Clowney in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. In motion, Seferian Jenkins. Stafford now to throw. He's going to air one out. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. The Jets on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be third and 15. Slot man moves right. Third and long. It's Stafford. He's going to look deep down the field. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up fourth.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay, because the second part of that is, if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Stafford will stay out there. He'll lead his guys up to go for it on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to go for a big play down. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And they will score a pick six for the Texans TD. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll go down at the 2-yard line. What a disaster there.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Stafford here coming off his pick six. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
But you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
They'll throw again from their own end zone. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. A Jet first down, 18 big yards that time. So the offense has it first and 10. Stafford. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jadeveon Clowney in there to get him. And that is sack number 15 for him on the year. To throw on second down at Stafford. Badunas got it, complete. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
The Jets on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This time they face a 3rd and 2. From the gun, Stafford. And he finds Seferian Jenkins. The Jets on the move, couple of big plays back-to-back. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
Stafford on first down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. It's a gain of 7, and it'll make it 2nd down. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. To the air again, Stafford. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
The Jets on 3rd down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This time it's 3rd and 3. Stafford looks to throw again. Found his target. It's Anderson. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. They go play action here on 1st down. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys free.
Because they have, you're right, they have had no room to breathe. Second and 10, Stafford again. And down he goes. Jadeveon Clowney in there to drop him, and he continues to wreak havoc in offensive backfield. Sack number 16 on the year. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.